Let's explore how to modify the SAS Autoexec file in SAS Viya Workbench. The SAS Autoexec file is designed to automatically execute SAS code every time SAS starts. This functionality is particularly useful in customizing your SAS environment, specifically the SAS Viya Workbench environment in this demonstration. The Autoexec file eliminates the need for users to manually execute repetitive code at startup, allowing them to tailor their environment to their preferences and specific requirements. To modify the Autoexec file in SAS Viya Workbench, we first need to navigate to our available storage accounts and ensure that the home directory is enabled. Notice that my home directory is available. It's named Home and is identified with a small house icon. In SAS Viya Workbench, the home directory enables you to share extensions, SSH keys, configuration settings, and the Autoexec file across all your workbenches, because this location is automatically mounted on each workbench you create. Depending on your setup, the home directory might already be configured for you as shown here. If not, you'll need to create it by selecting New Storage and then New Home Storage Location. For detailed information on the home directory, please refer to the documentation. Let's return to the home page. Now, let's begin by starting a workbench named SAS Autoexec. If this is your first time creating a workbench with a home directory, it may take up to a minute. Subsequent launches will be much faster. Once the workbench is initialized, I'll select Open Visual Studio Code. Then close the default window. To set up your SAS Autoexec file in SAS Viya Workbench, follow these steps to access the autoexec.sas program. You can use the method of your choice, either the terminal or manual navigating to the file in VS Code. For this demonstration, I'll manually navigate to the Autoexec file in the home directory using VS Code. If you prefer the terminal, you can select the menu, Terminal, then New Terminal, and use the necessary commands. The home directory is found in home/sas. To manually navigate to the home directory, open the VS Code menu. Select File, then Open Folder. Then navigate back a folder. Select Home, SAS, and OK. Here are all shared files in the home directory. Notice that at the bottom, we see the autoexec.sas file. Remember, the home directory is automatically mounted to each workbench by default, so modifications made to any files in the home directory will be available to every one of your workbench instances, including the autoexec.sas file, which will be executed every time you start a SAS session. Typical uses of the SAS Autoexec file can include setting user-specific SAS options, like global options that are specific to your needs or preferences. For example, setting the default date format, setting the output display options, or defining libraries to folder paths or external databases that you frequently use. You may also use an Autoexec file to define custom macros and functions that you use across multiple programs. This ensures they are always available whenever you start SAS. To demonstrate, I'll modify the autoexec.sas file to set some macro variables and programs for my use cases to automatically execute every time SAS starts. First, I'll create a macro variable named homedir that points to my home directory, home/sas. Then, I'll compile my personal macro programs, which I consistently use. These macros are stored in the My Personal Macros folder within my home directory. In this demonstration, notice that I have two macro programs, getcwd and head. The getcwd macro dynamically identifies the current directory path based on the saved SAS program's location and stores it in a user-specified macro variable. The head macro utilizes the print procedure to display the first 5 rows of a table by default, providing a data preview. I'll close the program. By storing these macros in the home directory, they are automatically available in every workbench I create because directory is automatically mounted by default to the workbench alongside the user-selected storage. To include my folder in my compiled macros, I'll use the SAS Autos option. The SAS Autos option references my personal macro programs located in the My Personal Macros folder, as well as the SAS Autos argument that references the default macro programs provided by SAS. Lastly, I'll also include a note in the log for demonstration purposes. The note will state, my AutoExec file has been executed for this demonstration. I'll save the AutoExec.SAS program without executing it, and then close the program. Now, let's navigate back to the My Storage location. Select the menu, File, then Open Folder. Navigate up one folder by selecting the two periods. Scroll down to locate the Workspaces folder, then find your storage folder named My Storage. Note that your folder name may vary. Then click OK. Next, I'll close the VS Code tab and stop my workbench. Let's proceed step by step to confirm that my custom AutoExec file works as expected. Select Start to restart the workbench. Then open VS Code. I'll close the default window. To connect VS Code to the SAS Compute Server, we must run a SAS program. Once connected to SAS, the AutoExec file will automatically execute. Create a new SAS program named test.sas. Then I'll execute my custom head macro program on the sashelp.cars table. I'll execute the macro call. And take a look at the results. Notice that 5 rows from the sashelp.cars table are shown, confirming my custom macro was compiled by the AutoExec file. Explore the log. Scroll to find the note AutoExec processing beginning. This default note indicates the AutoExec file was executed. Scroll down to find the other note, AutoExec processing completed. You can also see the note, my AutoExec file has been executed for this demonstration. Next, I'll execute my getCWD macro to create a macro variable named path with the location of the current directory of the test.sas program. Check the log for the note indicating the current directory path, workspaces/mystorage, confirming the getCWD macro worked correctly. View the value of the macro variable path by using the %put statement. Notice that the path macro variable points to the workspaces/mystorage folder as expected. We see that the AutoExec.SAS program I modified works in my current workbench. Let's test it on a new workbench instance and storage location. I'll close out of VS Code. Then stop the SAS AutoExec workbench. Next, let's create a new storage. I'll select Storage, then New Storage. I'll name the storage test_storage and specify 1 GB as the storage size. Then I'll go back to the home screen and create a new workbench. I'll select New Workbench. I'll name it Workbench Test and leave the default compute size. Then for storage, I'll select my new storage, test_storage, and select OK. Now I'll select Start to spin up my new workbench and select Open Visual Studio Code. Since this is a new storage location, I don't have the test.sas program I created in my other storage location. SAS Viya Workbench enables you to create multiple storage accounts for your specific needs. Let's go and view the AutoExec file in the home/sas directory and confirm it has the code we added previously. I'll use the terminal for this. I'll select the menu, Terminal, then New Terminal. In the terminal, I'll use the code command to open the AutoExec.SAS file from the home/sas location in the code editor. Notice that my home directory was mounted to this location, and the AutoExec.SAS file contains all of the code I added earlier. Close the AutoExec.SAS file and the terminal. Next, let's create a SAS program named new_test.sas. Then execute the %head macro to preview 5 rows from the sashelp.air table. When I run this statement, VS Code will connect to the SAS Compute Server execute the autoexec.sas file from the mounted home directory, compile my custom macro programs, then execute my custom head macro program. The results show 5 rows from the sashelp.air table. This is a simple example of utilizing the SAS Autoexec capabilities in SAS Viya Workbench. By leveraging the SAS Autoexec file effectively, SAS users can streamline their workflow, compile custom macro programs, ensure consistency in settings and configurations, automate routine tasks, and more. It can enhance productivity and reduce the likelihood of errors in your SAS programming sessions.